So this is a second video on the new features of OpenStudio 1.1.0, and this is highlighting the new cloud Amazon EC2 simulation options in PAT, or the parametric analysis tool. So this is a project I've already made that has 75 different measure instances, and I've made one design alternative with each of those. So the first two tabs should look pretty much like they had in the past. When you go to the third tab, there's a number of new changes. So to start with, in the past you had to run all these simulations. Now you can pick specific simulations to run, or you can select them all. The baseline has already been run, so that's why that's not highlighted there. So I could run these locally, but the new thing is the ability to run in the cloud. And so what I'm going to do is go to Cloud Settings. So currently we have Amazon EC2. There could be additional ones down the road, and we have a link to the website there. Once you set up an account and give them your credit card, because you'll pay them directly for this time, you get an access key and you get a secret key that you can set up. And just to show you what the website looks like, this is the website here. So once you agree to those terms and continue, you have some configuration options. So for region, this is the only option. Your server option, you do have a few options, but you can probably leave that alone. And there's two different worker instances here. One of them has 8 cores and one of them has 16. There'll be more options there over time. Currently I'm going to use 2 workers. So the idea would be that I'd have 32 simultaneous simulations here, and the server kind of manages the process for you. There's information here on pricing, but just as a reference, I believe the server is about 50 cents an hour, and each of these 2 workers is about $2.40 an hour. There is no 10-minute charge. Once you start one, you pay for the full hour, even if you only use 20 minutes, but that gives you a rough idea of the pricing. But we do recommend, as you're working on things, that you keep up with your pricing on Amazon, and you can actually manage the consoles and make sure they shut down properly. So we'll talk about that more a little bit later. So I'm going to save my settings here, and I'm going to go back to PAT, and I'm going to turn on the cloud. Now this will take a number of minutes, because it's actually, we have copies of OpenStudio with Energy Plus sitting on Amazon, and this is spinning up copies of those on a server that you're starting, and then it's spinning off workers. We'll see this stop spinning, and it'll change to cloud on, and this run button will become enabled once this is done, and it'll take a number of minutes. What I'm going to do while we're waiting on that is jump here to Amazon. I'm going to go to my console. And EC2 is what we're using. And I have 3 instances running. So this is what's nice to keep open and make sure it shuts down properly so that you're not being charged for time after you want to. But we should shut them down, but it's just good practice to kind of follow up. So we have 1 server and 2 workers. This one we can see is still initializing. So we'll come back here in a minute. So now the cloud has started up, and we could start the run. But before we do, if there's certain simulations we know we want to get detailed results for, the SQL file, we can check those here. But we have an option on the fourth tab to get this after the fact. So once you notice, oh, this design alternative is really promising, and I want to look at the detailed results, you can do that after the fact. But this is just an option to do that before. You could pick them all, but the thing is, we're going to possibly run hundreds of simulations. Let me click start, and then I'll talk. So we're going to run, you know, hundreds of simulations, I think for a 200 data point example, it took about 40-50 gigabytes of data on the hard drive to store all the SQL files. So the nice thing about running on the cloud is we can grab the high-level results we need to produce the reports we want, and then throw away the SQL files unless we want them. The cloud is still on until you turn it off, and you have an option to download them then. And if you forget, you can always do a local run later to recreate the detailed data. So we can see that these are changing to running remotely instead of not started. And if I go back to the website here, I'm going to actually click on the server. This is something you don't have to do at all. This just gives you an extra view into the model, or to the analysis and what's happening. But for this video, it's a good demonstration. So what I've done here is I've copied a basically address from my selecting the server. And then when I view that, there's a project, and then there's a simple project analysis. And I can see all my data points here. So there's the 75 data points. They're all getting queued up. And once that's done, we'll see 32 of them start to run. And as results come in, we'll actually get some of the UI results here and can look at the HTML table. So we'll just give this some time. Let's actually jump back into Pat. And we'll wait till it says it's running. It'll switch from starting to running. So we can see now that it says running on cloud instead of starting, and we do have an option to stop the job, but I won't. And this 7 minutes here is since we first clicked the cloud button. So it took anywhere from 4 to 6 minutes to turn on the cloud, and then a few minutes to upload all the data points and get the jobs running. It will not necessarily run them right now in the order you see. So some of them are running here and some of them are waiting. And if we go to back to the console here, we refresh this. We can see which ones are running and when they started, and the end time will show, as well as the overall runtime. So we'll let this first job run. I think these simulations take maybe 6 or 7 minutes each, and so we'll probably have 3 cycles of that, so we can run all these in maybe 25 minutes or so, including the time to start the cloud. But we'll come back when some of the first batch finishes and look at some of the results here as well as in PET. So we're now 11 minutes since we first clicked the cloud button, and the first batch of simulations has finished. And you'll see that they are no longer yellow, but they're grayed out because they've been done. And the same kind of data we had on the local run here, the initial and final conditions and any warnings that we might have from our measures show up here. So we can kind of inspect what was happening at various stages. So we can jump to the results tab. And it'll take some time here. And again, they don't run in order, so that's why we're seeing some and not others. But we can start to look at the results here as they finish. If you decided you wanted to get the detailed results for one of these, just select it, and then you can click here to download the results. And again, you can do this after the whole job's done, as long as you haven't yet shut down your server and your workers by shutting down the cloud, which is something you do on tab 3. So just to show you what's happening here, if I refresh this, the ones that have finished here give me the EUI, because it's metric, as well as the runtime. So that's not just Energy Plus, but that's the process for the measures and everything else. And if we want to look into the HTML out here from Energy Plus, we can look at that and see the energies breakdown or other data we want right here. But that data is downloaded even if you don't get the detailed results. This comes with the high-level results that comes with every job. But you have everything here, so you can go to the table of contents and look at the envelope summary and look at all the data about that. But I'm going to jump back to our kind of overview console. I'll probably jump back here. I think I've shown everything I want to there. So of course these are still running. Once we're done with all the jobs, we are going to shut them down through the parametric analysis tool, but we can come here just to confirm that they did in fact shut down. And when you do that, you'll see that they're terminated, and they'll probably stay up here for a few hours, just letting you still see that they were there. But once it's not running and it's on terminate, then you know they're down. And if for some reason you ever need to manually do it, you can select them here, and you can just go to terminate instances here, and that will shut them all down. The parametric analysis tool should then tell you it lost its connection to the cloud. Reasons you might want to do that, outside of if something happens to your project and you don't have access to it anymore, you might kick off a job, shut down your computer at work. When you go home, your job is finished. You can then shut down from any web browser or even an iPhone or an Android application. But we're going to hop back here. There is a failure here. Actually, this one was designed. So this was really a test project, and so the other failures were kind of design failures. In some cases, the measures would fail. In some cases, Energy Plus would fail because it was missing objects it needed, which is what happened here. This just gives you a summary of completed, and then of those completed ones, what percentage had failed. So anyway, I will probably pause this for a while, and we'll come back just to see it finished at the end. So it's been 18 minutes here, and you just missed it when you blinked, but this turned green because it was finished, and now that it's done that, it's set up for another run. So that's a little bit of a change in behavior. It used to sit here and show you that it was 100% complete, and now it looks like it hasn't started. But the fact that nothing is yellow here means that none of those are selected. But then I just click here to turn off the cloud. It'll say stopping cloud. And again, this will also take a few minutes. But if we want to see what's happening there, we can come back here and we can refresh this. And I don't know if it'll be that quick, but soon it should say that it's starting to shut down. And so that'll happen for a few minutes. So again, I won't have you watch this whole thing, but I'll show you what it looks like when it's done, and then we'll confirm on the console that that they are in fact shut down. So now the cloud is down, and if we go back here just to confirm, again, they still show up here, but they show us terminated, and that's fine. Those disappear a few hours later, but as long as their instance state is terminated, then you're not on the clock anymore with them. So one thing I didn't mention, so if you started a cloud run and you quit Pat, Pat knew you were on the cloud, and it will try to reestablish that connection when you start back up. So it tries to protect itself from that. And again, once you do need, during the starting part, you need to have Pat running and your computer on. But even if you shut it down and start it, it will remember that. And if the servers happen to be closed, then it'll tell you it lost the connection. It'll ask you if you want to restart the cloud to rerun them. So there's a lot of logic going on to kind of manage this process. But it is still new, and so definitely keep an eye on the console to make sure it's doing what you expect it to. But anyway, hopefully you find that useful. There will be more features coming with this. This is just the first kind of version of it, but we plan to add more to make it more robust and have additional features over time.